Hi all and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I'll be showcasing you that how can you delete all the files and folders within a directory without actually using loops. Like you don't have to get all the directories, then put a for each loop, then iterate and keep on deleting. And many a times it is required or it is expected out of you that you write such code, clean code or a one-liner code without using a lot of if-else and without using a lot of for each, just to make the code look easy, simple and clean. And you learn it on the fly. It's not a rocket science, obviously. And as UiPath is a low-code platform, so you're not expected actually to know all of it, but it's good that you know it. And I'll be trying to cover everything that I know and I could put in, like how do you actually achieve all these tasks without having to use the loops and all. So let's get started. Now we see here that we have an input data directory that has two folders, class A having two files and class B having three files. What if we had to delete it? So the main, the approach usually what everyone follows is that you'll use to get all the directories from this folder. Then you'll iterate on each directory. You'll get all the files within one directory, then iterate on it and delete one by one. So it's two loops that you will be putting in to delete it. And we'll see how do we do it without any loops. We're gonna just drag an invoke code here. We'll pass the argument that actually contains the path to our directory. So we'll name it in directory and we're gonna paste the path here. Now we have the path to the directory, which has two directories inside it. Now let's begin writing the code. So it's very easy. I'm gonna explain everything. So array.foreach is nothing, but you're putting a for each loop. Once you've put the loop, now what you have to do is, you have to get all the directories that are inside within the input data directory. So it's simple. We know how do we do it. We do it by directory.get directories. If you do not get this option, like the IntelliSense to see all the functions that are available, you can press Control plus Spacebar to get it. Usually you get it yourself, but if you do not get it, you can press Control plus Space and you get it. So directory.get directories. Now I'll be passing the path that you have as an in argument, that is in directory. Now, once you have all the directories with you, you'll have to iterate on each directory by calling a function. So you'll call a function which would iterate on X. So X is nothing but each item of the loop or of the array. And once you have it, then you are gonna do directory.delete. And once you see this delete function, you see that it accepts two parameters. First is path as string and the other is recursive as Boolean. So you're gonna do the path would be our X and recursive as Boolean would be true. And we click on OK, and that's it. That's the one line code. You can put a try and catch so that in case if you encounter anything while running this code, you actually see what the error is. Usually what happens, it is always, always advisable to put a try catch here in the invoke code, because that way if there's any error in the invoke code, you'll not be able to trace it if you have not put try catch. And these are the folders. Now I'm gonna run this. And we'll see how this just one line simple clean code has helped us actually to delete all the directories that are present here, and it's all gone. Isn't it magic? So that's how you delete it with the one line code. Now we even have a files folder here, which is three of six files in it. And now if we have just one directory in which we got to delete all these things, so for that also, you don't have to do anything, you just have to make few minor changes. Instead of get directory, you're gonna do get files. And instead of directory.delete, now you're gonna do file.delete. And there is no need to pass this Boolean parameter as well. That's it. Now I'm gonna save it and I'm gonna change the path. So our path now is files. Let's open it, let's change the path. That's it. I'm gonna click on OK, save it and run it. And everything, all the six files that are present here would disappear, right? so that's how you do it. I'll try to cover all these things in the upcoming videos, like all the shortcuts that I know and all the clean small code that I know that can help you write the code and make your program look clean. So I hope you liked the video. Please don't forget to give a thumbs up if you've liked it. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Stay tuned and happy automation.